Hi friends, welcome back to Raman Tutorials for GK. This is Rajkumar from Chitradurga. Today I would like to discuss common errors in English. So this is a very important question for the point of competitive examination. So usually there will be a question on this topic that is called error identification. Let us discuss some of the sentences and let us see on which part so there is an error here. Okay, so let us go to the first sentence. He likes cutting jokes. Here in this sentence we do not use cutting jokes, because cutting gives different meaning here. As an adjective for jokes, we use cracking. So cracking means, you know, making someone to enjoy. That is why. So we always use he likes cracking jokes instead of cutting jokes. Okay. Let us go to the second sentence. It is a true fact. It is a true fact. So here the mistake here is, true and fact both gives us same meaning. That is why this is not a correct sentence. So the correct sentence is, it is a fact. So there is no need to use true here. Fact itself means true. Next sentence, Radha resembles to her mother. Here in this sentence they used here to. Actually, you know, resembles someone. We always, you know, the verb resembles. After that verb resembles, so we use someone. That is, for example, Radha resembles her mother. So we do not say that Radha resembles to her mother here. So here to is a preposition not used here after resembles. We have to just omit that preposition to. Radha resembles her mother. Let us go to the next sentence. Are you living in Delhi? See here the auxiliary verb are is used. Here it is wrong. So we have to use do here. Do you live in Delhi? Okay, when you use that, for example, in the assertive sentence, you can say that you are living in Delhi. You can say that. But here, when you make it into a question, that is interrogative sentence, you can't use are. You have to use do here. That is why. So, do you live in Delhi is correct. And the first sentence is wrong. Let us go to the next one. Please pay for your bill. Okay, pay someone something, that is there. So here pay someone something. Here for is not suitable here. So for is wrong here. So it is a wrong usage. Please pay your bill. That is the correct answer. So pay for, we can't use. Pay is a verb, and after pay we cannot use here. Pay for someone, we cannot use it. Okay, pay someone, that's all. Okay, that is why here it is a wrong. Pay for your bill is wrong. Please pay your bill is a right answer here. Let us go to the next one. The police is looking for the culprit. Here, what is wrong here? See, the police itself says that, you know, it is a plural. Police is a plural, and so the plural subject takes a plural verb. Here, this is wrong. Is wrong, because plural subject always takes a plural verb. That is why police are looking at for the culprit. Let us go to the next sentence. He said a lot to lies. Okay, you see here, he said a lot to lies. See here, lot to is not a phrase at all. So it is a lot of something, lot of lies like that. Okay. Always after lot, a lot of something we have to say. We should not say lot to something. So lot of something. That's why the first sentence is correct. So we have to use lot of something, lot of lies like that. So we'll move on to the next sentence. I have no influence on him. I have no influence on him. Here the preposition on is used here after influence. After influence, so we can't use on here. So here influence over someone is right here. So see here, I have no influence over him. Him means someone. So here, I have no influence over him. Over him, and I have no influence on him is wrong here. Let us go to the next one. I am too happy to see you. See here, I am too happy to see you here. Here, not necessary to use too here. I am very happy to see you. So here, too is not necessary in using here. That is why I am very happy to see you. This is the right one. Let us go to the next one. He invited me on tea. See here, he invited me on tea. See here, this on. Invited someone for someone to something. Invited someone to something. Always it should be like this. Invited someone to something. We cannot say that, invited someone on something. No. So this is wrong here. So always he invited someone to something always here. So the verb invited afterwards, there should be someone and to then something. That's why he invited me to tea. That is the right answer. Let us go to the next one. We go to the college by foot. See here, we go to the college by foot. Here, preposition by is used here, and this is totally wrong. Because, so only for vehicles, we use by. For example, we go to the college by bus. We go to the college by bike. We go to the college by car, like that. So we cannot say that foot. So instead of by foot, always we have to use on foot. We go to the college on foot. Or you can write another way also. We go to the college walking, like that also you can write. Instead of on foot, you can write that we go to the college walking. So by foot is wrong always, and we have to use compulsory. This is on foot. We have to go. We go to the college on foot. So let us move on to the next one. Public does not like it. See here, public itself is a plural. Public means not one person. It is a plural, and plural subject takes plural verb. But here, does is singular verb here, and it is not at all right. Okay, this is wrong here. So always, plural subject should take plural verb. That is why public do not like it. So we cannot use, so public does not like it. Always it should be public do not like it. So let us move on to the next one. This is somewhat true. See here, this is somewhat true. Here, somewhat is used, not completely true. So this is not completely true. In order to say that, the word somewhat is used, but this is not suitable word. Somewhat is not suitable here. That is why we have to use partially, not completely. So this is partially true. Okay, and somewhat, So this is wrong, and partially true is right. Always, you know, we should not use somewhat, and because, you know, it doesn't give correct sense. So that is why, you know, we have to use the word partially. Okay, so in order to mention that, you know, it is not completely true, we should use the word partially. Next, let us go to the next one. I do not like poetries of Keats. See here, poetry itself means that poems, not one poem. So poems, number of poems written by Keats. That is why, you know, there is no need to use that poetries. Okay, so it is just a poetry. I do not like the poetry of Keats, not poetries of Keats. So this is totally poetries. There is no word like that, and we have to use poetry. Poetry itself symbolizes a plurality, that is more than one, more than two, or more than two, like that, two or more than two. So let us go to the next one. I prefer lassi than tea. See here, I prefer lassi to tea. This is a spelling mistake here. So I prefer, so lassi to tea. Here prefer is there, prefer. So prefer always takes to, not than. I prefer to, like that. Always, you know, it takes to, not than. Than is wrong here. That is why we cannot use it. Always, you know, if you use prefer. So here, you know, we cannot say that this is a comparative degree. Preference here, okay, is which one is prefers. So always, you know, prefer takes two. That is why this is right. And I prefer lassi than tea is wrong. I prefer to lassi. I prefer lassi to tea. That is right answer. Let us go to the next one. Please give key to your watch. Okay, here in some our regional language we use that key, give key, like that. But here in proper and correct English and good English, we do not use that give key that to your watch. Okay, so instead of give key to your watch, we have to say that please wind up your watch. Please wind up. Wind up means, you know, so like that, you know, we have to give key. So that is the correct phrase we have to use here to give key, not this one. That is, you know, please give key to your watch is wrong. And so here, wind up your watch is the right one. Okay, let us move on to the next word. He gave a speech. See that word, he gave a speech. See here, give something, we can use that gave. But here he is giving a speech. So that, you know, for that, you know, this gave is not suitable here. So that's why we have to use made. He made a speech. Because, see here, gave something. Always, you know, this verb gave something. So it takes something, not words. Here, he made a speech. Made a speech is suitable here, not gave a speech. So gave a speech is wrong here, and it should be made a speech. He made a speech. Okay, next one. I will return just now. See here, it doesn't give correct meaning here. That's why, you know, I will return presently is the best option here. So, and this is not suitable, and it doesn't give correct meaning here. I will return just now means, so it is not at all a meaningful sentence. I will return presently means, you know, within a short time, within a few seconds, I will return. So this is the correct sentence here. I will return presently. And this just now, you know, that is not suitable. That is why I will return presently is the correct one. Let us go to the next one. He needs not worry. See here, He needs not worry. Here need not be considered as one verb. So that is why, you know, here the yes is used here. You see that yes is used here. So that's why, you know, this is wrong. It should be he need not worry. Because, you know, so we use this need not as a whole verb. Though there are two words, we use it as a verbs. That is why, you know, so need not, dare not, like that we use it. That is why, so need nots, you know, it is wrong. It should be need not. He need not worry. Let us go to the next one. He hanged his head in shame. See the word here, hanged. The present tense of see here, hang, present tense, hang is a present tense, V1, and hung, H-U-N-G, hung, that is past tense, that is V2, but here hanged is there, so hanged we do not use, and it should be hung. He hung his head in shame. So here he hanged his head in shame means it gives entirely different meaning. He has committed suicide, like that, you know, it gives meaning. That's why, you know, so he hung his head in shame. That is the correct one, and the above one is wrong. Let us go to the next one. The satellite has been sent to space. Okay, so usually, you know, see that satellite has been sent to space. See, yes, usually we send satellites to space only. There and we are not going to send satellites to any other city or any other country. No, we always send satellites to space only. That is why, you know, satellites has been launched is the correct one, and the satellite has been sent to space is wrong. Always it should be the satellite has been launched. Next one, send this letter on my address. See here, send this letter on my address. So here on my address is wrong, to my address is right. Always, you know, so send something to someone it should be. Send, see here, send something to someone. So always, you know, it should be like this, send something to someone. So that's why, you know, so this the above one, send something on someone is wrong. We should not use on here, we should use to here. Send this letter to my address. Let us go to the next one. Are you a member in the committee? See here, are you a member in the committee? So here the word in is not suitable, preposition in is not suitable here, and it should be of. Are you a member of the committee? See here, always, you know, member of something, it should be like that. So member of committee, member in something will not be there, and it is wrong. And always, you know, it should be member of something, that is member of the committee. Are you a member of the committee? So that's why, you know, this is right, and the above one, that is are you a member in the committee, is a wrong one. Let us go to the next one. He is fail in mathematics. See here, this is in the passive voice. He is fail in mathematics, you know. So this he is fail, no, not necessary, he is fail. So it should be he failed in mathematics. It is simple past tense, you know. See here, this is present tense they are used, and already he has failed. And thus, in that case, you know, we have to use simple past tense, he failed in mathematics. Already he has failed, that is why we cannot say that he is fail in mathematics. So it should be simple, and is not required there. He failed in mathematics, that is the correct one. Let us go to the next one. We reached safely. See that the word adverb safely, reached is verb here and safely is an adverb here. So we reached safely. See here, safe itself is an adverb, and no need to write safely. So we reached safe, like that. Okay, no need to use just ly, right? No, what we have a bad notion, wrong notion that always, you know, the adverbs ends with ly. No, there are some adverbs, they do not end with ly. They do not end with ly, and safe is the correct answer here. We reached safe. So next one, Sachin is good at good in English. See here, this is wrong because the preposition in is used here. And preposition in is not used after good. See here, Sachin is good at something, good at English, good at Hindi, good at mathematics, good at science, good at drawing, like that, good at music. So we cannot say that good in music, good in science, no. So this is wrong, and good at English is the correct one. Okay, let us go to the thing. Any, see here, this is very important to know. Always, you know, after good, you know, we have to use at preposition, good at English. Next one, my elder brother is in the teaching line. See the word line. And now, being a native speaker, so we, our mother tongue always influence here. And here, so instead of line, so we should use a profession. My elder brother is in the teaching profession. And so this is wrong here. Line is wrong. Teaching line is wrong. We should not use teaching line, because, you know, here line gives different meaning. So it should be teaching profession. Let us go to the next one. She does not know swimming. She does not know swimming. See here, instead of that, you know, so here it is used. She does not know how to swim. Here, so the gerund is used here, that is not required here. And so here, she does not know how to swim. That is the right one. And she does not know swimming, that is not suitable here, and it doesn't give a correct meaning. That's why she doesn't know. She doesn't know how to swim is the right answer. Let us go to the next one. Our examination starts from Monday next. See here, our examination starts from Monday next is used here. See here, always, you know, before the names of the days, from Monday, Tuesday, we have to use on. We should not use from. From is wrong here, and we should use on. Okay, so always, you know, so it should be on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, like that it should be. Our examination starts on Thursday, like that. So it should not be from Thursday. See here, if it is from is used from Monday to Friday, like that, you know, we can write that. But here only one day is mentioned. So that's why, you know, it should be only on, not from. Let us go to the next one. Thousands were injured in the war. Okay. Thousands were injured in the war. Here, the verb injured is used here. Actually, that is when we are talking about a war, it should be wounded. We should not use that word injured. If any accident is there, we have to use that injured word. But here, when war is going on, so it should be wounded, not injured. Okay, let us go to the next one. He has grown into a beautiful youth. See that beautiful, we are talking about a male, that is a he. He has grown. Sir, beautiful is used usually for girls, ladies, female, not for boys. So we use, for boys, we use handsome. So that's why, you know, so beautiful is wrong here. And so we have to use handsome. Okay, he has grown into a handsome youth, not a, he has grown into a beautiful youth. Only for ladies or girls we use beautiful, not for boys. For boys we use handsome. Let us go to the next one. There is no other alternative. See here, two words are used, other alternative. Alternative means itself means that options. That's why there is no need of this word other. Other is not necessary here. Okay, so other is because you know there is no need to use twice the same meaning words twice. So there is no alternative itself is correct and other alternative is not required. That is why it is wrong. So only just there is no alternative, that is correct one. Let us go to the next one. Translate this passage from English to Hindi. See here. So when you are translating from one language to another language, so you should not use this word to. So you have to use into. When you are changing, no, from one language, you are translating from one language to other language. So you have to use into. See here, translate this passage from English to Hindi, not English to Hindi. English into Hindi, sorry. So translate this passage from English into Hindi is the correct one, because always, you know, when you are translating from one language to another, you must use into. And if you use to, that is that will be wrong. If you use to, this is wrong. So always, that's why, you know, you have to use into. That is right. Let us go to the next one. I have learned this lesson word by word. See that word, word by word. Always, you know, it should be word for word. So I have learned this lesson word for word. And so after this word, after this word, we should not use this conjunction preposition by, and we have to use for. Okay. So if you use by, it is wrong, and always we have to use word for word. So word for word is right one, and you should not use word by word. Okay, let us go to the next one. My watch is 2 minutes behind. See that word behind. Okay, so here behind gives different meaning. Okay, so here instead of behind, the better word is slow. That's why, you know, my watch is 2 minutes slow compared to others, or compared to the standard time. My watch is 2 minutes slow, but it is not behind. Okay, so behind, you know, it gives different meaning. Okay, it is a preposition, it gives different meaning. So we cannot use that word behind. So it is better to use slow always. Let us go to the next one. I asked him that why he was late. See here. Here this is indirect speeches. Indirect speeches. I asked him, that is used here. Why he was late. Okay. See here. Always, you know, in the indirect speech, we should not, especially when it is an interrogative sentence. Okay, when you are changing that interrogative sentence into indirect speech, we should not use conjunction that here. Okay, so there is no need to use. Only if it is sentence is assertive sentence, we use that. But here it is an interrogative sentence here. So why he was late? It is an interrogative sentence. Okay, so that is why. So we cannot use that here. That is wrong. And so we should, this is right. I asked him why he was late. And if you use that is wrong. Okay. So because, you know, it is a interrogative sentence, and we have changed this into indirect speech. And when you have changed that into indirect speech, so that is not necessary, and we have to remove it. And I asked him why he was late. That is the correct one. So let us go to the next one. Burn the lamp at once. See here, burn the lamp at once. So he just See what the sentence means. Burn the lamp. Totally the lamp itself, you have to burn it and throw it. But here, actually, you know, what he wanted, what the speaker wanted to say here is light the lamp at once. Okay, burn the lamp, you know, so no need at all that one and not necessary. And it should be always, you know, light the lamp at once. Okay, so burn the lamp is totally wrong and always, you know, so you have to use light the lamp at once. Okay, so with this, I am going to conclude my class, and you must remember the sentences that are in red color are wrong and the sentences that are in blue color are right sentences. That you have to keep in your mind. And so with this, I am going to end up my today's class. And please, whatever may be your feelings, so your please give us a feedback, so it will help us a lot. And if you want to subscribe our channel, please call to our number. Okay, thank you. See you. Bye.